been waiting on the sunset. Bills on my mindset, I can't deny it. Getting higher, higher than my income. Income's breadcrumbs, I've been trying to survive. The glow that the sun gets right around.
Good morning, believers. That was good, right? Yes. Oh my goodness. Here, I need to take a sip of coffee. It's necessary. Okay. Good morning. Happy Thursday. We are on day 2 of ancient China. Announcements today. F class, G class. F class will see you at 9:30. G class will see you at 10:30. And let's see. Student council elections are tomorrow. Tomorrow. Please go join that Google Classroom page, watch the videos, and tomorrow go vote for who you want to represent your voice on student council. Because it is how representative democracy works. Remember that whole thing, the representative democracy, the pizza and the donuts? It was a fun day, very passion-filled day. Okay, I miss you guys so much. The memories are just, I love them. I love thinking about them. So we are going to jump right into it. Other than that, and today we're talking about the Shang and the Zhou dynasties. So what I want you to understand is that when you read today, you're reading section 1.2, and this word right here, Z-H-O-U, it is actually pronounced Zhou, like Zhou, the song, you know? Hi, my name is Zhou. It's a camp song. I got a wife, 3 kids, and I work in a button factory. One day, my boss said, Joe, are you ready? I said, no. He said, push that button with your left hand. And then you keep going until, like, you know, it's a camp song. Okay, I'm sorry. You know this always happens. If you know that song, let me know. I'd like to know if you know that song. Okay. So, we're reading section 1.2, Shang and Zhou dynasties, and I am going to read it now. So, if you need to go to book and listen to it there, bye. See you for the explanation. 1.2, Shang and Zhou dynasties. According to Chinese tradition, a ruler named Yu learned to control the floodwaters of the Huanghe and established China's first dynasty, the Xia. No archaeological evidence of this dynasty has ever been found. The first dynasty for which evidence does exist is the Shang. Main idea. The Shang and Zhou dynasties developed many cultural behaviors and beliefs that have become part of the Chinese civilization. China's first dynasty. The Shang dynasty emerged along the banks of the Huanghe around 1600 BC. A dynasty is a line of rulers from the same family. The Shang developed many cultural behaviors and beliefs that rulers would continue throughout much of Chinese civilization. They established an ordered society with a king at the top, warlords come next, and farmers at the bottom. The farmers helped advance agriculture in China and grew crops such as millet, wheat, and rice. The Shang also developed a system of writing using about 3,000 characters. These characters became the basis for modern Chinese writing. They first appeared on oracle bones, which are animal bones used to consult the many gods the Shang people worshipped. Priests carved a question on a bone and then heated it. They believed that the pattern cracks that resulted revealed the god's answer. In addition to their gods, the Shang people worshiped the spirits of their dead ancestors. The Shang believed these spirits influenced everything from the king's health to the farmer's harvest. To keep the spirits happy, priests conducted special ceremonies, often using beautifully decorated bronze vessels. Shang craftspeople were among the most skilled metalworkers at the time. They also built elaborate tombs for the dead. The dynastic cycle. In time, the Shang dynasty began to weaken. Around 1045 BC, the Zhou overthrew the Shang and became China's longest ruling dynasty, lasting about 800 years. The rise of the Zhou also marked the beginning of China's classical period, a time of great social and cultural advances that lasted for about 2,000 years. The Zhou adopted many of the Shang's cultural practices, including ancestor worship and the use of oracle bones. However, the Zhou also developed a concept known as the Mandate of Heaven to be a guiding force for rulers. They believed that a king could rule only as long as the gods believed he was worthy. The mandate led to a pattern in the rise and fall of dynasties in China called the dynastic cycle. During the first 200 years or so of their rule, the Zhou established a strong central government. However, during the last 500 years of the dynasty, the Zhou divided their lands among local lords. Eventually, the ruling lords grew too powerful and independent. They fought among themselves and disobeyed the Zhou kings. By 475 BC, China had descended into a time of constant war called the Warring States period. In 256 BC, the last Zhou king was finally overthrown.
Helps me realize it's just a journey. Drop your worries. You are gonna turn out fine. Oh, you turn out fine. Fine. Oh, you turn out fine. But you gotta keep your head up. Oh, and you can let your head down. Hey, you gotta keep your head up. Oh, and you can let your head down. Hey,
okay. So, the Shang and the Zhou dynasties. First and foremost, they are not the very first dynasties in ancient China, okay? The Xia is the very first dynasty in ancient China. However, we don't have archaeological evidence of this dynasty, so it's not fact and it's not opinion. Like, it's said that this existed, but we don't have the evidence that we need to prove that it did. So, the Shang dynasty, where is my map, my ancient China map? This literally happens all the time. Can't find anything. Oh my goodness. Okay. I got it. All right. So the Shang dynasty in 1600 BC, they emerge along the banks of the Huanghe, okay? And which is nicknamed the Yellow River. So think this area. And what they're going to do is they're going to conquer pretty much all of this. And they develop some pretty important things with regards to the China that we see today. Meaning they developed a system of writing with 3,000 characters, which is the basis of Chinese writing, the basis of Chinese writing that is still used today. They also used a practice of etching these characters onto animal bones, and the animal bones were heated up, and the way that the pattern of cracks happened on the bone would reveal to them the answer from the gods about whatever they might be asking them. So that is pretty important because that's a cultural religious tradition that then the Zhou dynasty is going to take on and uphold. Let's see. It also talks about how they created elaborate tombs for the dead. And we're going to talk about this not tomorrow, but next week. We're going to talk about an emperor whose name is Qin Shi Huangdi, and he has one of the most elaborate tombs in the world. And his tomb is so elaborate that we can't even get into it because there are high traces of mercury, and they literally believe that there are mercury rivers that will act as a trap if we try to get into this tomb, and that it will flood everything in there and destroy it. Say what? I know. I'm not kidding. Okay? It's crazy. All right. So in 1045 BC, the Zhou overthrow the Shang. And the most important thing that the Zhou did was they developed the mandate of heaven. And this becomes a guiding force for rulers, which says that a king is believed to be worthy to be king because the gods say that he can. So it means that the gods believe this king is worthy. He can rule. But when they believe that he's not worthy anymore, he's done. And a new dynasty will come in. Remember, dynasty is a series of rulers from the same family, okay? So this leads to a pattern of a rise and fall, or a cycle called the dynastic cycle. And it's just a rise and fall of dynasties. So I prepared a little song, you know, of course. Maybe you'll like it, maybe you won't. But it goes like this. I might mess it up the first time. I really don't want to. Okay. Zhou Dynasty developed the mandate of heaven, guiding force for rulers. Gods said kings were worthy. With cycling, the dynasties. Oh, I know. I didn't mess it up. Yes. If you know, you know. Okay. So let's explain the cycling of the dynasties. It is called the dynastic cycle. First, the mandate of heaven has to happen. Again, the mandate of heaven says that this king is worthy by the gods. The gods believe that he is worthy. So because the gods believe that he is worthy, of course, all the people are like, yes, yes, you know, this king. What ends up happening as the dynasty starts to weaken. And then the third thing that occurs is that disasters occur, okay? And I'm talking natural disasters, meaning maybe they're not producing as many crops as they used to. Maybe the Huang He, the course of the river, swift as a coursing river, maybe it completely changes direction, okay? And causes a huge flood, causes problems, kills people. Natural disasters occur. When these disasters occur, the people are going to believe that the gods are saying that this king that's ruling is no longer worthy. This king, he has to go. And yes, I say he because men were people that were in positions of power, not females at this time. And so then, when the people believe that the gods do not think that that king is worthy anymore, the dynasty is overthrown. And a new dynasty comes in and rules. And the same thing happens over and over and over again. So again, Zhou Dynasty developed the mandate of heaven, a guiding force for rulers. Gods said kings were worthy. With cycling, the dynasties, or Zhou dynasties, you know? It's like, I'm here for it. Okay, now, the Zhou dynasty rules until they start to appoint local lords and rulers of the area that they're governing. And all of a sudden, these local lords and rulers, they want more power, and all of China, all of the Zhou dynasty. And again, I don't want you to think that all of China, all of China is not the Zhou dynasty. Okay. We're talking like this area right in here. Okay. That's the Zhou dynasty. All of it descends into a period of time called the Warring States, where they're just at war with one another. Remember, there's no outside forces because China is isolated. There's no outside forces for them to unite against. None. So that's where we're at today. And that's it. I hope that you have a great weekend. I know that it's Thursday, one more day of the week. Got to keep your head up. Love and mean it.
My hands in my pockets, kicking these rocks. It's kind of hard to watch this life go by. I'm mining the skeptics, skeptics, man.